what I was doing so you'd like me.
Right, right. And that is where so, our purposes started to cross,
right,
because
so,
I wanted to do it, you know, not to just be useful.
I wanted to
but
to
I started
be worth
teaching,
my pay.
Teaching you big the, you know, empowering you, but then at that point when you were going to be gone in 3 weeks, it was like you do what I tell you. Yeah, god damn it. See, but she bosses me around. She tells me she's, you know, little, you know, wilting Lily that she is.
Yeah,
she gets empowered to tell me to sit down. See, she did it.
Only
let's
lately.
Let's hear Diane.
Only this visit.
For a change.
Isn't that true?
Yeah,
what?
You're contradicting me at work.
I was at work.
You were giving me a hard time at work.
You
were being insubordinating. Yes, at the
oh,
end.
Oh, shit.
When you said, don't, no, I want you to teach me this. And I was like, no, you do your job.
Oh, I didn't know you felt
Come
this
here,
way.
Sweetheart.
No, I mean, wasn't critical of it. But I understood that you saw me as being sort of a son of a bitch. And I can be, but I was not. I had an agenda, and it was heavy duty at the time, and
oh,
you were not
sweet.
Staying. And so my patience
why?
Was.
Why did I die?
Well, I had 8 new employees.
Oh, I know.
They
I
all,
was just trying
walked
to keep
the
them
hall,
off
great,
from
great, great,
just
great, great.
Being all.
No,
so
just,
they were all into such a
well,
little
are,
complaining stance.
Yeah,
I was trying
you know,
to
we
keep fi- them all
we
calm.
Hired Fonda, and I that was the biggest mistake that I
was
made
it?
In the hire. I mean, I hired really good people. But Fonda, and you picked up on her complaining, and she just...
Oh, that thing. Whole place was complaining. I thought I helped a little bit with that.
Well,
I mean,
well you
not.
Did
Maybe
because you helped order
me.
It. But you helped order. But you, what, have you ever moved big time in an office? You know,
I was always petty little,
As far as physically moving your arrangements or moving your position.
Your office.
Oh yes, twice,
yeah,
three
eight,
times.
Office
just finished a major.
8 new employees.
Yeah. It is hell.
Everybody
is
just really, you know, territorial.
Oh, and Sharon. We,
you're
you know,
gonna
Sharon
do that? You're gonna put my stuff over there?
So.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
And then that
woman wasn't
from
good
India
enough.
Was just
no,
like she wanted everyone to be differential to her class.
No, it's what
is
it was.
She still with you?
She, yes, and she's still got her problems.
I did not take a liking to her.
Yeah, well, I like her. She knows
it. I liked Sue. Strong.
Yeah.
That's
Susan
the one I
Strong.
Like.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry, Greg.
Well, no, that's the workplace.
That's
sounds like to me.
Well, but I was, you know, at that point.
Sounds like work to me.
It may be a little hard to be friend and employee.
Sure. No, I was keeping you as an employee at work. That was it. I mean, you're gone,
yeah,
going,
maybe,
and
maybe
I couldn't.
Maybe there at the end I was having trouble maintaining that myself.
Well, when you wanted me to teach you things that you weren't going to even remember because you weren't going to go back on IBM's,
yeah.
You weren't going to do Macintosh, and you weren't going to do design, and you weren't going to do stuff that I would have hung in and really worked with you patiently, but I just didn't have the time at that moment to do it. Now, this summer, it would be different because this summer I'm hiring. Donna's pregnant again, I don't believe, and there's no replacement. And Carmel's gone, she had been married. Carmel.
What about
Carmel Losi is pregnant. She's gone. And so it's
but it
just
was,
a measure
sort
of the fact
for
that
me
people
to
are,
be, you know.
Oh, you loved it. You loved to be pushed around by me, didn't
you?
Stop. Get to work.
Are you kidding?
Yeah. Now, Leslie,
no, anyway.
You were obviously...
Say something nice
pretty.
Or I'm going to start feeling bad.
No, but you were pitched highly because you were evaluating what you were going to do and what was going on in your life. You were very into making those kinds of decisions.
Yeah.
And it was big, tough, big stuff for you.
Mm-hmm. And now you have a house.
Yeah, now you bought a house.
Yeah, now
nice
I come back
house.
Here and see how beautiful everything is.
But
here!
Leslie's
well,
got
beautiful.
Her baby pictures and you in there, you'll see them. It's a lovely little house. It's a great little house, actually.
Sure.
So you don't need to be... That's a wonderful house. I'd love to have that house.
My little tiny house.
Yes, I love that house. It's a great house.
My
I
house
can tell you,
house.
I'd make a Japanese garden
yours.
In the backyard there. And
Japanese garden.
Oh,
now.
You bet,
oh,
with
yeah.
vegetables too.
And lots of fruits.
But
lots of
Japanese
fruit.
Don't
so
normally.
So tell me.
Do, but
Diane.
I love that house.
Well, she's still after me.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no.
Well,
I'm talking.
I'm sorry, Leslie.
What is your point of view on the past? What is your memory of? Of course, I'm being entirely narcissistic with this question.
Do you remember Leslie? Is the question.
I know.
No, not that.
Did you think back on her friendship? Do you think, God, she was a good friend?
Yeah.
We had
we
such
were good friends.
Time.
We were really good friends.
We were inseparable
for
a year, for sure.
Yeah.
Our beanies.
Yeah. But we didn't like
remember
each other
beanies?
Initially.
Remember our beanies?
Our beanies?
We always wore those old beanies I had.
Oh, yeah. It's brown.
And a red and white
brown.
One.
Brown wool thing.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Those are little clothes.
Long phone calls.
Long phone calls.
And I hate talking on the phone, so that says a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, I hate talking on the phone.
See?
So what do you think it was? I mean, what did you share? What was the common thread?
I loved corrupting her.
And I loved saving you. But I think you succeeded
really?
And I failed.
Every savior needs a savee, isn't it?
Well, I think probably the different directions that we took were mainly based on our family lives, that they were so different.
But do you really think they were very different?
No, I don't. I just think that, I don't think they were a lot different. I think just the fact that my parents split up and hers didn't. And I'm not saying you should have. I'm just saying that does have something to do with
how
decisions
do you see
I made.
What is the difference?
Both of them fairly pietistic, fairly, I mean, other than your parents splitting, there was a straight and narrow, moral.
Judgmental mothers.
Strong mothers, very strong
mothers.
Strong mothers, more passive, quiet, remote fathers. Your father.
Your father was more kinder than mine. You didn't
yeah.
have that end of it at all.
Your father made you pay a price for
price
when you disappointed him. It was chill out.
And he's just become a kind person. He's got this new wife, she's just a saint. But I still keep my guard up and I still
and your father is just a nice guy.
He's always
been nice. Amazing. A little long
suffering.
He doesn't
talk.
But Ramon.
Yeah, and I realized that, I don't know
nice,
what I think, because
nice
I don't ever see them anymore.
Yeah,
but I'm scared to death of your mother.
He was gentle. He was a gentle man, but he was so remote. But I'm beginning to wonder if the problem is really there. I mean, I always thought it was a problem with my mother.
Well, you can, that is that dynamic.
Because I can't talk to him. I want
right.
him to talk to me.
Right. But I've seen a lot of...
I only found out in the last year that he was dyslexic.
Really?
I never knew that. I mean, it's like my father never wrote me a letter, and I would take this as an insult. Now I understand why. But I mean, it's really hard to... But he's judgmental, too. But he makes my mother verbalize
do the work
it.
For him.
Right.
That's a good job.
And she's very well.
She can't go.
Probably not as much as one would think, though.
But she's the one that reaches out.
She overfunctions in that.
I don't really know. And most of my opinions of mother, at least, is just terrified. Mothers,
you have their own with her, though. You were
I did once
very strong when you were
well,
older,
when
I
would run into your mother and father after
they
you
liked
were,
you.
Your mother liked me very much, but she always seemed to focus on the fact that I had a career. And she was always very,
like that.
Very, very energetic and very supportive of the fact that, you know, I ran into her a couple of times with a briefcase in my hand, and she just really loved that.
Yeah.
And that was the whole focus of the conversation.
Yeah.
I wish Leslie would do something like this, and then I'd get defensive for you.
Yeah.
Would she say that outright? Yes.
That's, yeah.
And then
I'd
get very angry
after,
at her.
This
first.
Was after I left?
God,
yes.
And that
really?
Dumb Leslie, I mean, she went and got a master's at
right.
the University of Chicago.
And that
Chicago,
made me angry that you were doing things that I wanted to do, and your mother's saying
affirm.
That I'm doing what she wished
yeah.
you had done. And I'm going, that's not Leslie. I don't like what I'm doing. You know,
yeah.
I mean, I don't
that
get this.
Interesting.
Right.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah, she always liked you. She thought you were
cool. I had to hold my own because she scared me to death.
Yeah, well, she probably liked you sort of up front.
Well, you know, I think the fact that I was sort of a wilting, sort of guilty, sort of...
Well, you like your father. She
weak
probably
person.
Didn't.
She, I think that's what almost egged her on. Because I once I started to hold my own a little bit more, She's laid off a little bit more. Or we just, I don't take it as hard. It's weird.
Yeah, well that's...
Because from what I've heard, Linnea doesn't have any of these kinds of problems with them at all.
She's been well adjusted
right.
from the word from the get-go.
Right. Because they didn't raise her.
She just doesn't
let
take
her
it.
Be.
Well, not like. Or she didn't take it as seriously as I did.
That's what I meant.
No, I would take so every hard. Little thing and just.
You were just
glue onto
sensitive.
It and make it more and more. Yeah, too sensitive.
That's what
I love that.
Don't
I think
listen to how they say it. Just listen to what they said.
Once, yeah. Everyone ought to do that to another person once in their life. You're just too sensitive. It's a terrific way to invalidate another person's feelings.
Yeah, they did that a lot.
That is a horrible rap. I've heard a lot of women who have mothers who you're just too sensitive, and I think it's
15 times a day.
Yeah, so don't feel. Mm-hmm. Don't feel. Remember that.
It breaks raising
above
women.
All.
My mother, her one big comment to me was before this, she was very concerned. She told me before this reunion, she said, "No, they came out and visited me, and I was excited to be coming here." She said, "No. Now that you've got your house, now you've got to stop working in the house, and you've got to just, you've got to rest now, and rest your body so that you look good and you look pretty for this reunion,
that's
and
bad.
I want you to make sure that your hair is all real nice, and I want you to make, you should go get a manicure. I really think you should go and get a manicure now. You just rest, and you take care of your nails."
Yeah.
She's utterly serious. That's right. If my friends are going to validate me on my
nails,
I don't give a shit. Get a lot of those nails.
Yeah, right. I find, you know, guys, it's not going to be a good deal about nails. Good nails are where it's at. I suck.
And it's better if they don't have any.
Well, yeah, but, you know, they got to look good. You know,
what time is it going
to
be?
You know, it's
6:30. We have to sort of watch it, don't
we?
Yeah. What are we going to miss?
It goes 6 to 8. This is a reception that's 6 to 8 at the pool. And I suppose then people go out.
Now.
You know, people
gotta,
do their
we've
thing.
We've got
to
do it now.
Go out.
Because I have to go
come back here or whatever.
And then we
where is she?
We got to do it.
Say mouse.
We got to do it. I mean, like,
well,
now.
Well, I buzz while we... Well, you have to... I mean, I'm going to put it... Well,
I'm
so
just
going to take my jeans
I have to take
off.
On... I have to put
I'm
on
just
going to
do it some preppy-looking thing and be on my way.
Yeah, I suppose Birkenstocks are not cool in Minnesota.
Oh,
no, everyone wears them.
They
yeah.
do?
Yes.
These
this
are not
Minnesota.
Uncommon here?
No, this is Minnesota.
Okay, so I'm not going to...
They're nationwide.
No one's going to stereotype me.
They're
Minnesota is, you know, like, where it's
we're
at
hip.
For hip sort of...
Especially male graduate Minnesota kids are really...
Oh yeah, so you gotta.
Okay,
so I'll go get
I'll my
jeans.
Earthy.
You guys get ready.
Okay, I'm getting on my dress.
God, I gotta tell you, Crystal.
You getting on your jeans?
What
no,
a
not jeans.
Deal.
So I'm just going to wear some khaki type trousers.
I think Diane and I loved each other.
We did.
Even though we were so different, we just loved
yeah,
each other.
I don't
other.
Know. It's I try to figure out if you were so different.
Huh?
Different
Maybe
than
we're not that
what?
So different.
Maybe you were so different
we
than other people.
No, different from
or
each other.
What?
I always thought we were really different, didn't you? Didn't you think we were an unlikely combination?
Yeah, we were. Yeah.
Because
Maybe
you
we were
too sensitive
because
and she
I
was
too
hard.
I was Miss Goody Two-Shoes, uptight.
You were sort of, you had your own two, you had your own realm of too sensitive, too, didn't you?
Oh, I always constantly told myself to be
yeah.
too
you
sensitive.
Know,
that's still
that
one of my, it makes me a bad employee.
Well,
so
you know,
sensitive.
Because, in fact, you did a lot better at me getting pissed at you than
oh,
Diane
I would be
used to.
Rent.
I mean, Diane would just, was just, you get mad at her and she'd just close up like a shell.
They still do that, don't they, Liz?
That's correct.
I don't think I got mad at you. Did I ever get mad at you? No.
But, you
Diane
know,
is
not
the
so
only
so
person in my life that I tried to defend. I remember that.
Yeah,
remember
I
that?
Defended you. It's your mother, so you should have a briefcase.
Do you remember yep. that? That you were in the bathroom or something and somebody said something mean to you and I got really mad and I hit the wall with my hand or I wanted to or something?
Wow.
What was that?
I don't remember.
It's the first time I was inclined toward violence. Was anyway.
And I hope the last.
Okay, now I'm getting silly. Around this time.
I was silly enough and now I'll go get
silly.
Crystal Jean on
mean
the scene.
So, you're leaving. I'm the only person left here in this film.
Well, Luke can interview you.
You know, I could. Don't ask me what I think about it. I don't want to record it.
Do you need a beer now?
I like it. Yeah, I'd love a beer.
All right.
I don't want to have it recorded. I'm willing to pop off as long as no one ever records what I have to say. So you have a lovely yard.
Thank you.
You've done a nice job.
Thank you.
On the whole thing. I'm so impressed because domestic, simple sort of domestic life, I think, is really some of the most important thing in life. Your flowers, your yard, your colors.
I agree.
Are you acquainted at all with Carl Larsson, the Swedish painter,
no.
Printmaker? He does scenes of his domestic life, basically his children, his house, but his house itself was the work of art more than anything, and it's wonderful. Color, and so what do you think of with Scandinavian color and design, simple, clean, mm-hmm. but and sort of sweet, but there's also that an outlandishness too at times in some of the things they do. Some of the blue, the use of blue, well, your living room is really outlandish in that way, where you know you just go whoa, they just really dramatic and fun. Anyway, that they're. His point, or what he said about his life, was to just achieve just a simple domestic elegance that was documented in his artwork. And I don't know that anyone would ever assert that it was great art, but very worthy of attention and very nice, lovely stuff. So. So, are you a computer user? Do you use the Macintosh?
I've tried to, but...
Design on it at all?
No. What have I done on that? Some house accounts, things like that.
Yeah. In spreadsheets?
Yeah. Nothing creative yet. Have to practice a little more.
Do you have a desktop publishing program? Like Page or Quark?
Diane always punches it up, so I don't know which one we use.
Yeah. It's a great tool for anyone who wants to design.
You have to have a color monitor.
Yeah, I just got one. A Mac 2 with a color monitor. That was the perk the more the vice presidents get. The computer, sort of almost of their choice, although I should have done more if I was really, I just thought I had to keep a lid on them. But it's really nice to get a big screen.
Yeah.
I was always happy just working in the part that I do so much big that I just, to have a bigger screen really just was really nice.
Dan just got a laser printer, and that's really made it a lot more fun because you really get some quality work right there at your desk.
So here you have a laser printer. So where are you from?
North Dakota originally.
Really, where?
Devil's Lake.
Terrific. I'm a great fan of North Dakota.
Me too.
I think North Dakota is one of the more beautiful states in the United States, which is something that most people wouldn't appreciate at all, but the wetlands and the marshes. It's not what you think of. I mean, it's not what but people imagine.
Right.
They think of Nebraska, dry, flat, what have you, and don't realize that it is probably the most important source of bird life.
Mm-hmm.
In the continental United States because of all the wetlands and lots of birds and on the flyway for ducks and geese and pretty throughout but also and then dramatic in the west.
Mm-hmm.
of Badlands. Yeah. So I'm a great fan of it. It's hard to know what'll happen to North Dakota agriculture. I suppose they'll hold on. It's semi-arid enough that it's not gonna, that it should do pretty well agriculturally. That I would think that the number of farms are gonna, the minute, dwindle to virtually nothing.
The average must be 10,000 acres.
Yeah, and then the small town life is sort of withers with that because there's not a population to support towns. So what do they do now? What do the big farmers do for community life? Nothing. They just have their farm. And
of course, when I lived up there, you didn't have that much of a community life either in the 50s.
Country church and maybe the town for foodstuffs and school.
Mm-hmm. Not even school.
Not even school, right. Small, country school. Right. Yeah, it's amazing.
And two of our neighbors up there had planes.
Yeah.
A lot of farmers have their own planes. And because there are fewer farmers, those that are there are prosperous.
Yeah. So, and they, do they fertilize by plane now, too? Or do they use pesticides?
Oh, yeah.
Herbicides, too? Sprayed?
Yeah, they're. Well, I'm not sure now, but they sure were when I was a little kid there.
But, you know, I read in the Smithsonian Magazine, which is a great magazine. It's actually worth subscribing to. It's $25 for the year, and they have, it's great articles, just wonderful things about American life, American history that you don't run into in most periodicals. But there was a great story about organic, sort of an organic agriculture movement that focused quite a bit in North Dakota, where people have just pulled away from chemical fertilizers and pesticides, herbicides, because they're so expensive and the yield in pulling away actually increased, so that you'd think, in fact, that they could farm more cost-effectively with a little less in the way of petrochemicals on that land, which is pretty expensive. But the land isn't really burned over either, like, you know, places in Virginia where they grew tobacco and really burned it off. But there's not a lot of topsoil either. It's very rich, but it's not deep. Not eroded, though. Not eroding like Iowa. So, great place.
Yep, and it's actually warmer than Rochester, on average.
In Bismarck, but not Devil's Lake. I mean,
it's real close. So
eastern North Dakota. I mean, I lived in Moorhead, Minnesota most of my life, really, 17 years out of it. And Moorhead, and far, far Moorhead was colder than Minneapolis and Rochester. But maybe once you get out of the valley, it warms up right away, because you do see that. You can see it on national weather maps, where the high pressure, cold high Canadian high pressure systems block in at the Great Lakes, and they swirl. But it'd be high, so its high pressure is clockwise, and they swirl like this, cold, but it's like down to Rochester, or down to into Iowa, and then up to Fargo, and then the west warms up. And you can see it. I see belts of in Bismarck that are the same temperature as Baltimore. Below the Mason-Dixon line, which is pretty amazing.
Also,
we got chat. I forgot.
Special thanks.
Will that do it?
You bet. So, you're going to go get Crystal.
Yes, I just called. She goes, okay, I'm getting ready.
Good, good, good. And do you take the dogs? Are they car dogs?
Only to the vet.
Just
they
the
are
vet.
They are lap and bed and constantly.
And what are their names?
The little guy is Bob.
Bob.
And the big guy is Bentley, but we call him Ubu.
Ubu.
Ubu-doo. Hi, Ubu.
And how long have you had?
Since Bentley I had before Lewis and I met, so he's adopted. And Bob we got about 6 months later.
Well, take care of your maternal instincts.
Yes, they do.
Normally.
Sort of
put a real chill on maternal instincts.
Whenever I get the urge, I just grab Bob
and hold
put a pacifier in his mouth, and I'm happy.
Hold, maybe diaper.
Yeah.
It's
carried around in a royal pillow.
It's a surrogate thing.
Works out well.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I bet the Steve Ryan chair.
To the what?
We're going over.
Oh, God.
Yeah. That's
who was he?
That's what we're saying.
Steve Vine, did you ever think he was cute?
No. Not
remotely. I'm sure a lot of girls did, but you know, but the thing is, I think he's pretty homely now.
I bet. No bangs.
Yeah, I mean, he doesn't. I mean, the guy, he knew he wasn't going to wear four of those. I gotta tell you.
She's okay, but she's doing fine.
She's recovered?
Yeah.
Recovering, probably. So, we've got a newcomer. We've got a.
Oh, that's okay. It's out here.
Yeah. So we
are. Here we are. Oh, this is where we're going. Somewhere in the way.
I was going to dug out some of your poems that you wrote me in high school. And I forgot to bring them.
No other lover. No one sings that song as well as you do.
Something in the way she moves me.
Venus.
Great, but
I
hear that song.
Sure. Do you?
Oh, yes.
Hi, doggies. Hello. I know you love me. I know I smell like something weird because they just love it. Of course.
Oh, my God. Crystal Jean Richardson.
On the scene.
What a vision.
And I still use my maiden name.
What a fabulous vision.
Oh, I can't keep up with this.
We need this.
This is the latest picture of my two girls. And I don't have one of Brit. This is a glamour shot of Kirby.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
And that's all I have right now.
Sit
still long enough
for her. Oh, she's pretty beautiful.
And he didn't want to be like
that. How old is she now?
She's 8. She was 6 then. Yeah, look out for her.
Oh, she's gorgeous. Oh my goodness.
I'm going to smoke somebody's cigarettes.
Oh man, if I manage to get through this. time without smoking.
Don't smoke.
Oh, did you just quit?
I quit a year ago, March.
Oh, a year ago.
This is going to be the biggest test of all time.
Why?
Don't be tried by it.
I'll let go now, right now.
Breathe this fresh air. Enjoy these people.
Oh, that's really. He was only 4 years old
then.
He
still looks like that.
That's my first.
Still,
he was three then.
No.
Oh,
so
it adorable. Says three on back.
Oh, they're so adorable.
He's 11. He'll be 12 this year.
Man.
That's the one you came and visited me right after I had that.
Yes, right after.
So do you like North Carolina or Chicago?
I love Chicago, but I do not like cold weather. I never have.
You never
and I never will.
What do you think of Charlotte?
I think it's a stupid place.
Yeah.
Very stupid.
But the weather is gorgeous.
Warm and stupid.
Right, just warm and stupid.
It is. And it's like warm. Freeze, you do freeze to the
front. It is. It was really hot when I left.
Charlotte is.
Did you like that? You don't mind that?
I hate it. I don't like anything. This is the person you're talking to now. I don't like shit, okay? I don't like my kids. I don't like my husband. I don't like my house.
And the weather sucks.
I don't like anything.
Yeah.
But she's happy.
But I'm happy. I'm well enough to, I feel that I can say that. You know, I used to be really inhibited about letting people know how much I hate everything.
Yeah.
And now I don't care.
Okay, so that makes
sense. We sort of caught that. Though.
Right.
I remember that hatred for the cold.
Uh-huh. Well, you've all gotten out of it.
Well, I tell you, it's
my mom won't come back. My brothers won't come back.
I hate to wash the dishes.
They're in Arizona. They will never come back.
And I don't. They could stack up to the ceiling. I've never touched a dish. But I have good friends and family. They come over and wash my dishes for me. Guys want to hear one of my latest things?
No.
Oh, we don't have time.
Tape.
Robert?
No.
Oh, what is this tape, though?
Yeah,
it's a song that I've got.
It's really good. It's excellent. We should listen to it.
You're still singing?
Should we or should we go?
Well, we should go because
then we'll listen to it.
We'll come back.
In what way?
We're doing some studio work with a guy who's written some original songs for me.
Oh.
And I still sing. I sing with a jazz band.
Oh. Yeah, I mean, really seriously, I can hear your voice. I can just think about it any kind of.
Well, for a long time, I wanted to put one of your poems to music. I just can't find it. Do you remember?
Which one?
I would like to make love in the rain.
Yes.
I don't
have
one.
This.
Do you have it?
I don't have that one, but I've got some poems.
I wrote this.
Wrote it.
And I've always loved it. I made a big poster of it once. And there's another one I called.
Little Lutheran girl.
There's another one.
I don't write anymore at all. I don't even remember.
I don't either. I don't write, but I dug your poems out because you wrote really neat poems, really nice ones.
Yeah.
And
remember this. Take it. Say it.
And this is 20 years late, but I have them in my trunk. They're all down in there.
Yeah.
I got my Southtown dresses in that trunk, and I got stuff in that trunk I didn't even know I had.
The orange ones.
The orange ones. And the pink ones, too.
Senior year, our year, you didn't wear orange ones. That was that orange was the year before.
And how we danced around with our skirts up to here, I don't know.
They're bad now.
Oh, I know, but I haven't had the courage myself.
Yeah.
Oh.
You will.
Oh,
you guys look just the same to me. I swear, it's just like 1972. Especially you. You just look like a little boy.
That's not true. I do gray hair. And I'm
please.
Yeah, you do look a lot
alike. He does. He just looks exactly the same to me.
Yeah. Exactly. Didn't change much.
I should show
hair.
You.
That's all. In college.
No, they'll have pictures.
You just had longer hair in college.
I never know what to make of that. It's not changing. I mean, people's, you know, should grow up.
Well, I know, that's why I'm not sure whether to take that as a compliment.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I should have had a little more adventure in my life or something. I should have changed.
And your hair is just gorgeous.
Oh, yeah.
Just lovely.
I love your hair.
I'm beginning to appreciate gray hair. And I just think it's great.
I've had something else. I've had that for years.
Yeah.
Years and years and years.
When did you get the gray? You told me about that.
26? I don't know. While I was teaching it, I was huge.
Anyway, the first time I saw it, I went, God, that's bad.
People think it's fake.
No, bad. It's not. It doesn't.
No.
But I mean,
you arranged it. Yeah, but I streaked my hair.
So Leslie was thinking very much about dyeing her hair.
Because I didn't want to look like that.
Then that would look fake. Yeah. You know, if you dyed it brown or something, then you'd look probably
really
stupid.
Gray hair that's dyed takes on a whole life of its own. And never looks
you
got to
make it blue. You know, blue ladies. I mean, if you're going to get go of that way.
Jane Addams thought I should go black.
Oh, no. And that would really be harsh.
I feel really guilty about Jane Addams because I let her to believe that she and I would be flying here together.
It
is your fault.
I know it's my fault, but I can't really take this.
And I never got back to her about it. I let her on to think she was going to come with me.
Leslie, you're here.
Greg.
Aren't you happy that I got Leslie?
I am.
I'm really happy.
It's true.
I could
Greg.
Just stand on my head.
You're adorable.
So,
but you'd ruin
your
dance.
You know I appreciate it.
What am I doing? I haven't combed my hair in a few weeks.
Even
so I hope everybody appreciates this.
Hey, we should be taping this. We've been forgetting this whole thing.
It's a half a loaf, but I tell you.
Oh, were we taping ourselves?
No, we weren't. It's the problem.
Oh, I don't want to.
Oh, I do.
Oh,
yes. Come on.
The thing I like about Diane is she's the only one that ever laughs at my jokes.
Diane's a very loving person.
I'm accommodating.
I don't know if it's loving.
I think so.
She just thinks he's got a head sense of humor.
No,
that's love.
When I called you on the phone all the way from Oregon, I couldn't believe how warm you were to me. It just bowled me over.
What did you think she's going to say? Scandinavian nature.
Why are you calling me, bitch?
That's what you might have said.
Who the hell are you? I've got my life now, please.
Southtown,
that was a long time ago.
Oh, I love it. Listen, I dug out old pictures. I have Southtown pictures out this weekend.
Oh, good for you.
That picture of me and Billy Carnes hugging.
Yeah.
See, my mother's having a reunion this weekend, too. She just retired this week. And so all my family is home, people I haven't seen in years, and all the little kids and everything, and I'm so glad I had this to go to because they are driving me insane.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, you know, it's how much.
The reunions don't come around very often.
No, I thought that too. I'm really glad Greg told me. I was lost.
Well, Tommy Swan is the one who
Tommy Swan called you?
Well, Tom and I kept in touch.
Oh, really?
But, yeah.
Okay. And I'd like to see him, too.
Yeah.
I'm curious about
the thing about Tom is that Tom and I...
I want to see Bill Barnes.
Yeah,
I do, too.
I have a feeling he's not going to be here.
Oh, he's going to be here. Yes, he's both nights.
Oh, my God. Say
it. Martville.
Oh. I told my mother not to let me forget.
Did I write this? Did you write this? I wrote this. I gave you this.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I was so idealistic. What's happened to me? I've lost all my
Tom is not like me. I mean, we're really quite different.
But were you ever?
No.
No.
And that's the thing. But Tom Swan is the one person.
Undivided devotion.
Who I know that I turn to.
Really?
If I really need to know Tom, I know.
Yeah, but you don't have to be alike to have that kind of relationship.
Right, he is, you know, but he's a mind. He is my fast friend, which is funny because he's happened since Tom. You know, we don't see him.
Did
so Tom sent me that fax. It was on green. I couldn't read it.
I
kind of
love this.
What happened?
Well, he sends you this fax of the details about this reunion, and it's on green paper.
Oh.
Right? So that it's gray.
But I lost mine.
Indetectable words on the page. But at least you thought about it.
The week before. You know, you remember Mark. Mark Reynolds, did you tell him?
Mm-mm.
Mark lives in Charlotte.
You see him over there?
He married
Mark
Nancy
Reynolds.
Ambrose.
God, yes.
Is that our prom picture?
Yeah.
Steve. Oh, God.
I have so much
you
junk.
Be,
I love it. It's meaningless.
Pretty good.
It's meaningless.
Girl.
Very good.
abundance.
The calm was so smooth, yes. Leslie had no interest in it whatsoever.
I guess I didn't hide that, huh?
Well, you know, I'm so intuitive, you know.
Oh, yeah, no, but you were always telling me confidence.
No, not that.
No?
No? Just admitting.
Really?
And Marty Stubbs there. I wonder what. I'm
Marty
curious to see what he looks like now.
He looks exactly the same.
He does?
He looks just like that.
You're kidding.
I see him quite often. He
never liked me.
You know what my mother told me, though?
He was always down on me.
This is going to sound. My mother said. Marty's just sarcastic, that's all. My mother has seen people that she hasn't seen in 50 years. And I've heard her, I've seen her walk up to people and say, "You look just like you did at high school." And I'm thinking, that's impossible. That man looks ancient. But that's the way you guys look to me.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the way the people look to her.
Uh-huh.
Because
if you know someone, then
but I'm thinking, please. No, well, I said, why didn't you tell that man he looked just like he did in high school? She said, he does.
Yeah.
I want to tell you, there's a tie. I think Crystal and Leslie are the best
legs
in this picture. And
oh, please.
There's a lot of legs.
Oh, please. There was
a lot of legs in the early 70s.
I have the skinniest legs in the United States,
well,
I'm sure.
I've noticed.
Chicken legs. That's what my brother's
called. Yeah, look at those outfits. I can't believe it. And how could I have been so smitten with Steve Pine? I don't understand it.
Because he was
cute. No interest in
Greg and I have decided that he's probably extremely ugly
probably
at this point in time.
Everybody,
I think that
he
had a nice smile.
I lost all these good men because of him.
Yeah, right.
He was Adonis-like.
Yeah.
He was
Adonis-like.
At that time,
He's probably toothless now.
He's not toothless, he's just...
74.
Trim.
Yes,
sort of
then we went to
your
hair.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you keep in touch.
Wow.
Is
this
she's sort of dressed up.
Big
nine or
something. Oh, really?
Oh,
no, I'd love
to see
that. One of the things that, see, I went to Oregon, and I had a chance to go to Oregon, and I told Leslie the story. And I was so disappointed. But she didn't remember it because when we went to Big Nine in our senior year, we went in and we got off the bus in the early morning, and Smitty was he was agitated, a little angry and a little pissed off at us because we were so flat. Mm-hmm. And
he remembers that.
I remember that, but and he was irritated, and we all knew that he was irritated, and we got scared and sight. I told you
the
story,
part of it, yes.
But after I rehearsed you, because you didn't remember this.
That's
what
you taught
us
all to discover
the solution.
But I can imagine.
This was a moment that I was an indelible musical experience to me. And we walked out, and you know, he wanted us to do well, and we weren't really as good a choir as the year before, but we were starting to become musical.
The next 2 years, they were terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard those stories
terrible.
Afterwards, but we sang a couple times that year, but that day, like any the best choirs I've ever sung with, and I've sung with really good choirs subsequently, but that day,
that
I mean, because we were scared, and we did great music, we sang that day, Profundis, you know that, remember it? It was a fabulous,
but doesn't that make you think, wonder if he gave us... made us think that he was agitated on purpose.
No, but I don't think he was that could ever be that calculating. He just really wanted us
I agree.
To do well.
Yeah.
And
he was just nervous.
He wanted to be, us to be good for him.
We gotta go. We're gonna miss this thing.
It's almost
6:30.
But
for him and
it was
us.
7, right?
No,
it can't end.
When I called the guy's wife, she told me it started at 7.
I just love seeing you guys.
It can't just end.
Yippee Skippy.
Oh, well, just hug me,
De
baby.
De profundis, Greg. I can't even remember all the words.
I haven't seen you since Chicago. No, you came to visit me when I had the baby.
Coming.
No way. I'm
going to
stay away now.
Oh, I am, too. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here.
Okay, now.
That was also
Lou, are you still taping everything?
You bet.
Okay. Now, I need to make sure I have my camera ready.
I don't have a camera. Somebody send me a copy.
Well, kids, you feel really ugly. I have ugly attacks every other week.
I find that ugly.
I do. I sit in my room and I go.
Every time I call her, she has an ugly attack.
If you don't sit down and shut up,
I'm going to rip out your face.
If I take my clothes off and look in a mirror, I can forget it. I'm not leaving for 2 weeks.
Well,
I don't know. I understand that. I think Diane may have.
I have ugly attacks on a regular basis.
You can't judge. You're not a good judge.
No,
you're
too close to it.
You're too much.
Pajamas.
And I get a glimpse, and I go, oh, shit. Ugly tag.
Really?
Big tag. Way too ugly.
Where is the camera? Mine's right there if you'd like to do some shots.
I think it must be in the car.
Oh, man. You have it on video.
That's really something else. You can bring me copies?
Well, of course.
For everyone.
Oh, that'd be so great.
I don't want copies. I don't have a camera.
Yeah.
Somebody, y'all don't have to have a video, but I'd like to have copies of this snapshot.
Oh, I want to add on to it last summer with your kids, too.
Oh, the reunite. Gorgeous kids.
Oh,
and add on to that.
That would be gorgeous. Oh, thank you very much.
Hey, you're all right. I mean, I know they're there.
No, that's a long story.
It's a pain in the ass, but, you know, they're
cute. If anybody would ever like to hear that.
No.
Not tonight, maybe, but one day. Because I have three children. I've been married 2 times. And 2 are illegitimate. And that's, I think that was pretty good.
That is
nice. I've had babies in between marriages.
It's definitely subject for storytelling.
Mm-hmm. Sign of the times.
We have to have a pajama party. Mm-hmm. That's when we talk about stuff like that.
We have it in Leslie's room. She's got a mat on the floor. I have it in her room. Okay. Mm-hmm. Leslie's got the slumber party room.
Okay, let's get the show on the road. I have to take this roller or another.
Okay, let's go.
We're leaving now.
Time to move.
This is the way out. Come on.
You can bring your liquor.
It's Minnesota, though. String us up by our heels and tax us even more.
All
North Carolina, too. That's good. I'm through.
So here we are.
Here we are.
We're leaving.
And
we're on video.
Good night, sweetheart.
Good night. Yeah, it's a little song.
Oh, I'm going in the closet.
What?
You still do.
Well, thank you.
What?
Thank you.
We are.
You sort of think you might be all beyond that.
I don't know where my glasses are. And I guess it doesn't.
I never had glasses in high school, so I suppose it's okay. Goodbye, dear.
The cameraman's not supposed to talk.
Yes, I like it, though. But I'd like to kiss the cameraman. See you. Thank you. Have fun, boys. Say goodbye, Ubin.
Say goodbye, Ubin.
Thank you.
New Orleans funeral march.
Yeah.
Diane.
Yes.
Turn that off. This is a funeral march.
Just still, your voice is so beautiful.
Yeah. Thank you. It's a joy to hear any. I was going to say, and this is what I'm going to tell you, Sonny. That. Rick's picked it up.
Good.
I was going to tell you that. I always tell people that. I didn't know you were here, Tom.
Thank you.
We did California Dreamin'.
No, that wasn't your background. What background? What was it?
We have a medley.
Don't wanna leave him now.
You know I believe in how. Da 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 da.
Come on.
we have till we do traces.
Traces. I don't remember that.
Well, we remember it. We just can't remember the beginning of that.
Stop changing.
crazy.
Okay, now I'm going to sing that song.
I want y'all to thank you, thank you, thank you.
Hear what somebody else
do you need this? Yeah, Leslie. Mrs. Smith.
His name is Jerry. You really have to practice.
No, I don't call him Jerry. Okay.
He's got to try for a while. Then it gets much easier.
She calls him Jerry twice?
Mrs. Smith.
She does say that's Mrs. Smith.
She was talking of me. She said, I can't call him Jerry, but she said it two times, but she won't say that to my face.
Okay.
Leslie lived with me in Illinois when I was in Chicago. And we did a lot of stuff together.
Yeah. What did you call Jerry, Mr. Smith, even then?
Oh, yes, I did.
Now,
here it is. I see three ladies. Do it, girl.
Blowing smoke rings from their mouths. Well, they fly the sky with a gentle ease. Please take me with you, cloud lady.
Cubes.
Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Sounds like it's coming out wrong, and I said, because I never really know how to tell you that.
She said, oh,
God, I music, I bet you would think. So she just always said them, you know.
Think about those people
just how much I love them.
Thank you.
Come on, so song right now.
Who?
Because he heard that song, son.
Who?
committed suicide because he heard that song so.
Oh no.
There will never be another you.
Oh, I love that song. I do that.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Good show now. 20 more years.
Another friend of mine calls it the Shepherd's Lament.
You know, I'm starting an institute for the
I'll
get out. Yes. Get quiet. Let me tell you. tell you something, Mrs. Smith.
Go for it.
Mrs. Smith. Smith. Mrs. Smith.
Bristol, practice a couple of names. Jerry.
Now listen to this.
You go home and say it, isn't that hard?
Why? People, Smith. Sonny, they don't look like that after 20 years.
No.
Most of the people are fat like me. They short and fat, and they, hey. Don't let these people fool you for any minute. You know.
I know they're.
Look at this. Look at this. You know. No. There's no way. I don't know where she's been. She's like it's been some kind of a maybe refuge or something. But it deserved you for 20 years or something. The rest of us don't look like that. I mean, it's just unbelievable.
You've been
something. Five years.
Really?
Retire from teaching.
Oh, no.
Come here, sweetheart.
He's had a couple of things.
Yeah.
But I don't know that I
would. You would, yeah,
because
you
used to. Yeah, I know.
Is that
the name? No, because my sister was really good friends with both of the kids.
What's that?
Now, Bob McElroy's family.
Now he's two siblings. And then his mother, too.
Well, yeah, I imagine. Was big time.
Rob McElroy.
Yeah, I know.
Vincent's a real, I just know through the grapevine, some real, very, very tough family stuff. And he was, I don't know if you talked to him at all, but he was.
I just said hi to him. He was really distant.
Yeah,
like,
he's, and he saw, he's just like,
kind
he can't go straight at you.
But he was so
boy,
very.
Oh, he was just like Mr. All American jock.
And the family was like that too, but they had family secrets, which was depression. Nothing more. It was like, they and it's amazing that you can be in a medical community and, like me, will not get depression treated. Because that
well, except that Rochester is circa 20 years ago.
But yeah, but
and, you know, it's not exactly the most liberated.
It was not your favorite place in the world.
Well, it was just, I mean, there are a lot of stories like that.
Yeah, but it just seems amazing to me still, because they're all bright, terrific people, and just carnage in the family, but plenty because of the neglect of the term psychiatric disorder that was functioning. It was just, shouldn't happen. So they got all of me just like walking wounded and Rob, who was such a fine guy, all American.
He was not that fine, though he was moving in 6th grade.
He was. Well, you never forgot.
I didn't. That's
you have to kind of forgive 6th grade.
Now that I mentioned, think about it. You brought that up since 6th grade.
Yeah. It was such a, it was a wrenching thing. I should be in counseling for it.
Let it go. Make a little picture of it and, you know.
Forgive me. Throw it in the picture. I mean, this is yourself going up and saying,
I'm Marty's
house.
Diane, go 4 o'clock to Marty's house tomorrow?
Yes.
Marty's house tomorrow?
Save Smitty from Crystal.
Yes.
Someone save
him. Where does
Marty
save
tomorrow?
Smitty probably.
Crystal's out with Mr. Smith.
Yeah, Mr.
Smith. She thought she was pouring wine and she poured a whole glass of wine.
I told her what it was.
She didn't care, did she?
No.
Oh.
Greg?
You threw that down.
I'm sorry. I just wasn't thinking. I just.
That it was an emotional gesture that she shouldn't have it. Sorry.
I'll make more.
Greg, can I designate you to take Crystal
home? I'll get her home, safe and sound.
I know you well.
She's there, she's going to die on my couch and I'll be home at 6 o'clock in the morning.
I am.
That's just too far away.
Above all, I'm interested.
Thomas, would you like a little
that,
a bit
absolutely.
More stuff?
Oh, sure.
So Tommy, you haven't changed a bit.
Nope.
Since last time I saw you last time.
Since about a month ago.
From month to month, you never change.
Thank you. From year to year, you sure like a shit.
I was always sort of a shit, but I was so repressed about it.
Yeah, that's true.
I never let it. I never showed my true self.
You stopped repressing that, haven't you, recently?
That's it. Coming up more as a sort of the flower in my personality. Sort of stinky, but I'm trying to turn it into manure.
Well, it's worse. So.
Fertilizer.
How are you? I'm tired.
Well, you know, it is 2 a.m. plus.
I'm fine, tired.
But we we used to go at about this time to Perkins.
Yeah, that's good.
Coffee and coffee at about 4 in the
Ambers.
Morning.
Yeah, go to Ambers and
what
Ambers.
What time is it?
What's that fat food?
It is 2.
We need some butter.
Yes, yeah. Some butter and some lard. Yeah. just take that stick of butter and shove it between your teeth there.
I think, it'd be best if we could have some butter on and, sort of a little pig fat on. Beef muscle.
Yeah, just kind of chew it a little bit.
Mommy,
won't even just chew it. Well, that part was, it would be real boring without the booze.
Oh, everybody. Most things are boring.
Were you as a 10th?
Sometimes stay in my purse.
10th was even more fun. People got smashed crystal fast. And then they were all just kind of palsy. It was fun.
I think.
Tonight was a little bit more adult, a little bit more reserved.
Whoops.
That's okay. That's okay.
I don't know. I guess you find a lot of people are just like you, you know. We're all kind of bored.
Just like
you.
Boring old.
Boring old and making a buck and
just doing it, you know.
Yeah, just doing it.
Suffering, struggling.
Let me tell you something.
That was interesting. You know.
Did
you get a vote for now?
Well, see, I was just going to bring that up because Thomas here is lost.
Tom.
What's that?
Tom.
What? What?
We can't talk about it.
There's something that you can't change in people. Okay? And after 20 years, if those people are still doing what they were doing 20 years ago, hang it up. You cannot change them anymore. Period.
Who wants to change anybody?
Don't even try.
That's a good idea.
Don't talk to them about it. Because it's not going to work.
Okay.
Do you get my drift?
You bet. And he knows what you tell him.
Thank you.
Especially when you're telling him in that tone of voice.
Whether I catch it or not, I'm not.
Don't even talk to him. Don't try to get anything across to Greg, in other words, because Greg's going to be this way all in his life.
That's
so,
absolutely true.
I mean, this is
out. That's out. Right now. Now,
oh,
I'm trying to have a reasonable conversation right now. No. I didn't mean to sit on your lap. I was trying to get in your corner. Move.
That was a very hard move.
I was so comfortable.
With everybody being married and whatnot, you know.
But I said, well, you're married. I mean, you'd be making like some kind of an accusation.
Well, it is.
It is. He's married. You married. I'm married.
She's not married.
She's married.
I'm not married.
Leslie's not married. You're
so
married.
So it's an accusation. Yeah, hell yeah. It's a fucking accusation. I accuse you of being married.
I accuse you.
Yeah.
I'm guilty.
Yeah, don't try to act like you ain't married if you ain't married. Hell, you know. I know you married. Because they didn't already tell me.
Freedom.
Well, I hardly found anybody that wasn't married there tonight.
There were most people.
There's hardly any people in the world that's over 35 that is not even understand.
Oh, please.
There were a lot of same people. There were not many there.
Still.
There were not a lot of people there. But people. There were not very many people
I like
there.
Being on the missing list.
I know.
Okay. No, okay. No.
Leslie Greg, no. This, that wasn't good at all. At least you didn't make the dead people.
Missing.
Okay, can we go around the corner here since we've been truthful?
Sure.
Let's just help you.
Hey, I gotta tell you.
Missing or dead?
Yeah.
Are you being truthful?
Last time I checked.
What do you mean?
Are you being truthful
now or not? Dead, unmarried.
Actually, I'm hungry. If I was really truthful, I'd say I'm hungry.
Missing, dead, unmarried. I'm married.
I'm missing.
Really?
She's missing. It's also right here.
She ain't missing.
Yes, it's
just missing, married, or unmarried.
Well, I'm unmarried and missing to boot.
I'm unmarried.
Oh, you guys. Know what that is?
I'm married. It's on the brood. I'm married.
Half hour.
Everybody's being good pussies. They don't want to declare themselves.
Is there no?
Well, no, I was hoping.
That's how I feel.
Sorry.
All right.
Just,
you either want to be married or you don't.
Truth, man.
Yeah, but I mean, I was wondering how good we were getting. Yeah.
Bullshit.
Well, I'd be very truthful.
Are you married or are you not married? What's the deal?
Just hang on to that. Don't mess up my mother.
Yes.
Are you married?
Yes.
No. Okay, well, you can't say. You can't say what you just said.
He's divorced.
I'm divorced.
He's divorced.
What?
From a broken home.
I am a broken home. I love it. For how long?
Hey, this is getting good. Keep it up.
Yeah. No, strictly speaking,
Crystal's getting down.
Now Crystal's getting down to breast. I'm sorry?
I don't have anything to lose. I got a husband, children, and family.
Yeah, right. So you're not going to, you know,
so what do you have?
Much.
Are you celibate?
Let me tell you.